Hello and welcome to MHA Digital Communities. My name's Katie and today we're going to be doing some Spanish themed art. So let's get started. Today's piece is going to be what I'm calling a Spanish plant pot. When you go to Spain, you often see balconies with all these beautiful little blue or terracotta pots, all arranged in rows, and that's where I'm taking my inspiration from today. So this piece is a watercolor ink piece. So I'm just going to take you through the materials you're going to need. So to start with, it's really, really good to invest in some watercolor paper. This paper here is what's called 300 GSM weight paper. That means it's just quite thick. It's quite thick, this paper, if you look at it. And it has a slightly bobbly, not bobbly, but grainy texture. And this paper is really thick, so it absorbs water and it doesn't start to warp too much. So that's why it's good to use this. If you don't have this paper, just thick cartridge paper would do, but it's quite nice to be able to use watercolor paper. Then I've got in these little pots some what are called brilliant inks. So they're inks like you'd have in a pen, but they're for painting with. So you can see I've got some red, some blue, and some yellow. So just the three what are called primary colors, and you can mix the other colors from those. If you don't have these inks, you can use normal watercolors, or you could even use food coloring, but these again are a really good investment because a big bottle will last you years and the colors are super bright and super vibrant. The other important piece of equipment will be a wax candle. It's just an ordinary wax candle. Then I've got a pencil and a sharpener. I've got a selection of brushes here. So I've got some flat brushes, which are quite nice for applying quite big washes and for doing straight edged things like the plant pot. And then I've got a selection of small and medium brushes as well. And then I've also got three little plastic pipettes that I'm going to use to do a technique where I'm going to take little drops of ink and I'm going to drop them onto the page. So in order to work with the inks, I've also got my little palette here and some water. And it's quite good to have some tissue handy just in case you have a spillage. So let's get started then. So I've got my watercolor paper here. So I'm going to be doing this little Spanish plant pot. So I'm going to start off by using my pencil to draw my plant pot shape. Plant pot shapes can be a little bit tricky, but we'll just do it in a really simple way. So if we just start off and we just draw a short horizontal line like this, and then we're just going to try and just curve underneath it like that, just a slight curve. And then if we then about a couple of inches up, so perhaps 2 inches up, we're just going to put a little dot there, so somewhere in the middle, and we're just going to draw another little curved line, but this time we're going to draw it slightly wider like that, and then we're going to join these two ends together. Okay, now this looks quite short, but we're going to add the top part. We're going to just extend this out a little bit. We've got these lines that slightly go out, and then another slightly curvy line. If you find doing the curvy lines a little bit too difficult, or they don't look quite right, you're absolutely fine if you just want to do them straight. The idea of the curved lines is that imagine I'm sort of looking slightly down on the plant pot, so I just get this effect. But if you want to just have straight line there and straight lines there, that's absolutely fine. Okay, so we've got our lines like that sketched in. Now, the rest of the tree, I wanted to show you how to do something with really minimal drawing, because it's not about the drawing, it's about the way you're going to use the paints. So on the one I did earlier, I basically didn't do any drawing at all on here, which thinks, oh wow, you know, how can you do that? But I didn't do any drawing with a pencil. I just actually started drawing with a paintbrush. So we're going to go straight into that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go straight into that in a moment. I'm going to get just my medium paintbrush. And I want to basically use plain water to create a series of little circles that represent these little rounded little fruits, like little oranges or little red flowers. So I'm going to start off by getting my plain water. I'm just going to move that so it's a little bit nearer. Now, if you wanted to, you could just draw to help you to see where you'd put the water. We could just draw, I suppose, a few circles there if that kind of helps to see. It doesn't matter if those show through. So I'm just going to draw a variety of circles. I think that might give you a little bit more confidence in where you're putting the water. So we'll just put those in. We can always add a few more in. Right, and then I'm going to take the water. I'm just going to show you how to do one. I'm going to just put the water in there. So if you can see that, I've got a nice amount of water. Then I'm now going to mix some red and some yellow to make like an orangey colour. So I'm going to take my pipette, and I'm going to have one for each colour. Just keeps it simple. And I'm going to get some red and put a little bit of red in there. And then a little bit of yellow. And then just kind of mix those up. Now, I'm just going to dab this with the ink from there, and you can see it's just kind of sitting in its own little puddle. And if I move that around, you can see it kind of just spreading into that area. Now, it is a little bit experimental when you do this as to how it looks and what happens. For the next one, that's already got orange on it, I'm just going to rinse it out for the minute and put some more water there. This time, with my pipette, I'll just empty this one out. I'm going to try and actually, instead of using my paintbrush, I'm just going to try and drop a drop of ink. And when it splats down, you can see kind of the edges sort of filling the space. So each time I do it, it will look slightly different. And this time, instead of dropping the drop, I'm just going to squeeze it out into there like that. And you can see each one changes. And this is the enjoyable kind of fun part of experimenting with these inks and the pipette. So that one just filled up the space. Let's try that one. So that one was just a tiny, tiny dab of ink, and you get kind of paler version. And what just that gives you is just an interesting kind of unusual edge. So we're just going to add something to those. Obviously, it all depends on the shape of the water. Whoops, I've just added a bit more in. There we go. You can also draw with a pipette as well. You can use it like a little tool, like that, so you could go. Okay, so those are, they're all there and they're drying. I'm going to add a few more small circles, so I'm going to just draw those in. One more there, and I'm going to just do those in yellow. I'm just going to put the water. And just, it's just such a quick way of adding colour because it's really quite instant. A magic wand, it just completely fills the space there. So those are kind of drying there. Okay, while that's drying, then I'm now going to think about this area here. So I'm going to take the candle and I'm going to, well actually I'm going to take the pencil first, and I'm just going to add here a couple of leaf-like designs at the bottom. You could add your own designs, you could add stripes, I'm just going to add those. And this one I won't need to add because I'm just going to go straight in. So I'm going to put a line across here, across the base. And then I'm going to put a wiggly line that goes along the top here. Might add another line there. And then I'm going to fill in my leaf-like shapes here. And this technique is called wax resist, because the wax repels any water or ink that you put over the top, just giving you a nice grainy white line underneath it. And then I'm also going to add some lines across here. And then this is still a little bit wet. Ideally I'd wait till this is dry, but I'm just going to proceed for now, just to get to show you how to do this bit. So what I want to do is I want to add a series of wavy branch-like lines in between my fruits and just all around, just to suggest the structure of kind of leaves and little branches. So I'm just going in. If you find it difficult to see what you might do, you could always use the pencil to just kind of plan out how you might do it, and it doesn't matter if that pencil shows. So you're just generally sort of branching out little lines in between, but don't worry too much because the effect will look fine. Just go in there, put general kind of little lines, some little scribbly lines. And you can always add a few more bits. Okay, so you should have this whole other invisible drawing at the moment, which will then be revealed once we add some more ink. Okay, so that's all drying. I'm going to do the plant pot for now. So I'm going to go with my blue ink. So I'm going to put some blue ink into the palette. Then I'm going to just wet my brush. And actually, I could change brushes just so I can show you. I've got this straight edge brush, which will help me do a nice straight edge along there, because I will go flat with it. So I will just dip that in there and go straight along like that. It gives you just a nice straight edge. And I'll do that on the other side. Whoops, not to worry, there's a splash. We're going to do it along here. And then I might just make a slightly lighter shade here by just adding a bit more water. You can always darken something. It's a bit harder to make it lighter once you've put the ink down, like that. And I'm going to just do it along here. Okay, I'll let that dry a little bit, but I'm just going to put a slightly darker amount along the top. A slightly darker area here. Okay, so that's the plant pot. We'll give that a rinse, and now I'm going to do this area here. So we'll just get some yellow. Now, as my water's already got some blue in, it may go a little bit greenish, but that's okay. We don't mind. We don't mind that. Yeah, so as you can see, it's like a lemony lime colour, but that's fine. So here where we have this little splash, I'm just going to work over that and just use that blue as it comes out. That's fine, we just get a different shade of green. Okay, so we'll let that dry and then we'll go back to this area here. So some of these are nearly dry, like that one's dry, a couple of them have got a little bit more. We can always use a little bit of paper towel to just dab those off if they're still wet and you want to work back into them. When they've dried, you tend to get a slightly darker area along the edge, and if you use two colours you tend to get them sort of slightly separating, so you get these quite interesting effects. So what I want to do is I want to go back to the ones that are dry and add another, perhaps another drop of colour. So I'm going to take my pipette and put some yellow into the palette here. Take a different brush, get some water onto there. So I'm just going to add a little bit of water. And I might, some of it's slightly bleeding out, a little bit more water there. Then I'm going to take my pipette and add another drop. So you can see that kind of fading out. There was an accidental extra one, but that's all right. So I'm going to put another layer of water over there and then add another layer of colour. Doesn't work the same if you apply it just onto dry because it won't spread out, so we're trying to just get it to spread out. So put some water on top of that one. There it is, some water on this one. Need a bit more ink. So we're starting to get more variation of colours. So we've got a red layer, we've got a yellow layer. And then I'm going to go back to these yellow bits and I'm actually going to just try and mix a colour where I've got some red, so I've got some yellow, and I'm going to add a bit of red into it. So maybe it's just a slightly different. And then I'm going to get another brush, go back over it, and then put a drop on. Oops. So you don't need to be precious about this, you're just really experimenting with just adding different drops and layers. It's quite nice when you get a pattern like that emerging. Quite nice to do that. I could still wait again or dry them with a bit of paper towel or even a hairdryer if you have access to one, and then even add one more layer. So I might go back and just make some red here. Well, some of these are still wet, I might just dab a bit of extra red. Okay, so each one is almost like a little mini art piece of its own, because each effect is slightly different. We've got quite a big gap here in between them all, that's where we're going to add the green. So you would wait till this is dry ideally. I'm just going to go straight in and just be a little bit careful. So I've already added my wax, so now I need to create my areas of green, and I've got three different shades of green. I've got a kind of medium green, a lighter yellowy green, and then I've got little areas, it's almost like a like a dark bluey green. So I'm going to start off with the lightest first. I've already got some mixed from earlier, which I kind of did underneath there. I'm just going to add a little bit more blue to that one. And just, I could always test it out on the side, let's just see. Yeah, so that's still quite a light green. So I'm just going to put some general areas. Now I know it doesn't look like leaves or anything, but it's really just areas of colour. So you can see there, that one's wet and it's entered into that one. We're not going to worry about that. Ideally you do this when they're dry, so we just put those little areas of green. And the idea of using the different shades of green is, of course, in nature you would see different shades of green, and this kind of impressionist style painting. The darker areas just create little areas where it just makes it stand out a bit more. So we've got this kind of pale colour, then we're going to go for a slightly darker colour. So get some of the blue and just add it into that green that I already had. Now we've got this darker colour. And just dab it around, just put little areas. Obviously we've got the wax underneath, so we're not really sure where it's going to show and where it isn't, but we just put little areas of the darker colour in. Making it slightly darker still by adding some more blue into the mix. I'm just going to take a little bit of the yellow . Hopefully making a slightly different shade. Yep, it's a slightly different shade. And now while that's drying, I'm just going to go back to the pot and add a slightly darker layer with my flat brush, just to add an even stronger layer of tone. I'm going to pop in a tiny bit of this green just to vary a bit. That's quite nice. You can see it's more of an ultramarine. And just put some more dark along here just to make that pop out a little bit. Bit along the top, bit around the edge. And there we have it, and that is my Spanish inspired flower pot. Thank you so much for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you in the next activity.